Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Kotlin. Today we're going to be creating our first Kotlin project and exporting it into a jar file. First, open IntelliJ. If you haven't installed the Jetbrains IntelliJ IDEA IDE, I made a simple tutorial on doing that. You can find that in the description. Once IntelliJ is opened up, click on the Create New Project button at the top. This will let us choose which framework we're going to use for the project. We want to use Kotlin, so go ahead and check the Kotlin/JVM option. Once you've done that, click on the Next button. Now we need to name the project. This will be a simple Hello World project, so I'm just going to name it Hello World. By default for me, it'll create the project on my desktop, which is where I want it. If you want to change the project location, click this small button to the right and navigate to the desired directory. Once you've got everything set up, go ahead and click on the Finish button. This will open up IntelliJ to your project, which you can see at the top left. Select your project and then right-click on the source folder. We want to add a new item, which is right at the top. Go ahead and select kotlin file/class. Now we can name the new file. Since our project is called Hello World, I'll just name the file Hello World. You can name the file whatever you want, but just so you know, you'll need to reference this name later. Press enter and your new file will be created in the source folder. At the top of the file, go ahead and write the following code. Also, just so you know, all of the code for this episode is linked to GitHub in the description. Feel free to copy and paste it into your code. Now that we've written to our Hello World file, click on the upper right and select File, then Project Structure. This will bring up our project's project structure. We need this in order to export this project as a jar file. Go ahead and select the Artifacts tab. Click on the plus button at the top to add a new artifact. Select the jar option and then the From Modules with Dependencies option. This will open up another window allowing us to edit the artifact we're making. Essentially, we need to tell the program where to look for the class of the file we just made. Now you may be thinking, we just made a file and not a class. That's right, we did not specify a class. However, IntelliJ automatically creates one for you if you didn't explicitly make one yourself. The name of the automatically created class is your file name followed by KT. Make sure that you capitalize the K because capitalization is critical to successfully exporting our project as a jar file. Back to the tutorial, if you've done the same things as me so far, your main class would be Hello World KT, so I'll type that in right now. That's all you need to specify for your artifact, so go ahead and click OK. Now you can see your brand new artifact. Go ahead and click OK to save this. Now we need to build our artifact into a jar. On the top left again, click on the Build option. Next, click on the Build Artifacts selection. This will bring up a small menu showing our artifact and giving us build options. Click on the first option. Once you do that, you'll see the build progress at the bottom of the IDE. It shouldn't take more than a few seconds. After it's finished, open your command prompt or terminal. We need to go to the directory that our jar file is in. You can locate this using the terminal or by using File Explorer. We do have to run the jar in the terminal to see the program output. Once you figure out the folder path, type in CD and then paste the path and hit enter. Now that you're in the directory, type in java-jar and then type in the file name for the jar. It'll probably be the only file in that folder, so you can likely press the tab key and it'll fill it in for you. Press enter and you'll see the program output. You've now successfully created your first Kotlin project and exported it as a jar file that anyone can run if they have Java installed. If this helped you out, please leave a like and subscribe for weekly Kotlin tutorials and coding challenges. Thanks for watching.